Hi, I am Sudarshan. We discussed about hypertension. Before getting into the topic, we should know the definition of blood pressure. It can be defined as lateral pressure exerted by the moving column of blood on the walls of arteries. The normal blood pressure is less than 130, 85 millimeter of mercury. Coming to hypertension. The hypertension has been divided into three grades: grade 1, grade 2, grade 3. Grade 1, the systolic BP was 140 to 159 millimeters of mercury. Diastolic BP was 90 to 99 millimeters of mercury. Grade 2, the systolic BP was 160 to 170 millimeters of mercury. Diastolic BP was 100 to 109 millimeters of mercury. Grade 3, the systolic BP is greater than or equal to 180 millimeters of mercury. Diastolic BP is greater than 110 millimeters of mercury. Isolated systolic hypertension can be divided into two grades, grade 1 and 2. Grade 1, the systolic BP was 140 to 159 millimeters of mercury. Diastolic BP was less than 90 millimeters of mercury. Grade 2, systolic blood pressure is greater than or equal to 160. Diastolic blood pressure is less than 90 millimeter of mercury. Causes for hypertension. First, age group. More than 40 years of males is commonly affected. High salt intake, obesity, heavy consumption of alcohol, lack of exercise, impaired intrauterine growth and low birth weight are associated with increased risk of hypertension in later life. Then coming to causes for secondary hypertension. The first and foremost causes for secondary hypertension is pregnancy, then renal disease, then endocrine diseases and coarctation of aorta. Renal diseases, which includes polycystic kidney disease, glomerulonephritis, renal vascular disease, parenchyma renal disease. Endocrine diseases, which includes pheochromocytoma, Cushing's syndrome, Kahn's syndrome, thyrotoxicosis, acromegaly, hyperaldosteronism. Hypertension has adverse effect on cardiovascular system. Intrinsic lamina thickened, smooth muscle hypertrophy, fibrous tissue deposited, which is seen in the large arteries. In case of small arteries, hyaline atherosclerosis occurs in the wall and lumen will be narrowed, aneurysm will be developed. Coming to clinical features of hypertension. Hypertension is usually asymptomatic until the diagnosis made or complication arises. The first clinical features is radiofemoral delay in patients with coarctation of aorta, enlarged kidney in patients with polycystic kidney disease, abdominal bruits that may suggest renal artery stenosis, fatty hump, which is a characteristic feature of Cushing's syndrome. Other signs of left ventricular hypertrophy, attenuation of aortic component of second, third and fourth heart sound. The severe hypertension can cause left ventricular failure in absence of coronary artery disease. It can cause hypertensive retinopathy. Other complications are aortic aneurysm and stroke. Coming to gradings of hypertensive retinopathy. There are four grades: grade 1, 2, 3, 4. Grade 1, which includes arteriolar thickening, tortuosity, increased reflectiveness, which is called as silver wiring. Grade 2, which includes grade 1 plus constriction of veins at arterial crossing, which called as AV nipping. Grade 3, grade 2 plus retinal ischemia. The ophthalmoscopy features shows blot hemorrhage and cotton wool exudates. Grade 4, which includes grade 3 plus papillary edema. Coming to management of hypertension. The management can be divided into investigations and treatment. Investigations, which divides specific and general. Specific investigations are chest x-ray to detect the cardiomegaly and coarctation of aorta. Echocardiogram, which has to be done to detect left ventricular hypertrophy, renal ultrasound to detect the renal artery stenosis. Urinary catecholamines, which has to be measured to detect to possible pheochromocytoma. Ambulatory BP recording to assess the white coat hypertension. Urinary cortisol can be measured for Cushing syndrome. Plasma renin and aldosterone can be measured for primary aldosteronism. Coming to general investigations for hypertension, urine analysis for blood, protein and glucose. Blood urea electrolytes and creatinine has to be measured. Hypokalemic alkalosis may indicate primary hyperaldosteronism. Blood glucose, serum total HDL and cholesterol, thyroid function test can be done. Coming to important part is white coat hypertension. We should know the definition of or meaning of white coat hypertension, which means a transient rise in blood pressure, particularly when blood pressure was measured by doctor. It will be prevented by automated devices at home. Coming to treatment. Drug therapy. First drug is calcium channel blocker. Amlodipine, nifedipine is commonly used now, which is commonly useful in elder people. Diltiazem, useful when hypertension coexists with angina. The side effects of calcium channel blockers are flushing, palpitation, fluid retention. Coming to AC inhibitors, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors. Enalapril, ramipril, it should not be used in patients with impaired renal function and renal artery stenosis because they can reduce glomerular filtration rate. The side effects of AC inhibitors are first dose hypotension, rash, cough, renal dysfunction and hyperkalemia. Coming to angiotensin receptor blockers, irbesartan, valsartan are commonly used now. These are similar efficacy to AC inhibitors, but they don't cause cough. Thiazide drugs, cyclopentiazide 0.5 mg can be used now. Used in older patients, which is contraindicated in patients with gout. Beta blockers, metoprolol, bisoprolol, which is useful in patients with myocardial infarction, angina, heart failure. Beta blockers are contraindicated in patients with asthma and heart block. Aspirin, antiplatelet therapy is powerful means of reducing cardiovascular risk, may cause bleeding, intracerebral hemorrhage. Other vasodilators include alpha blockers, prazosin, doxazosin, which is contraindicated in patients with urinary incontinence. Drug directly act on smooth muscle are hydralazine and minoxidil. The side effects are first dose and postural hypotension, headache, tachycardia, fluid retention. Minoxidil causes increased facial hair growth. Statins, which reduces the cardiovascular risk by treating hyperlipidemia. Coming to refractory hypertension. The refractory hypertension, it is a situation where multiple drug treatments do not give adequate control of blood pressure, which is due to genuine resistance to the drugs. The resistant hypertension can be caused by failure to recognize the underlying causes like pheochromocytoma. These conditions can be treated with spironolactone. Coming to accelerated hypertension or malignant hypertension, it is a rare condition that can complicate hypertension of any etiology, which is characterized by microvascular damage with necrosis in the walls of arteries and arterioles by intravascular thrombosis. The diagnosis is based on evidence of high blood pressure and end organ damage like retinopathy or cerebral hemorrhage. Left ventricular failure may occur if untreated. The patients will be die within a month. The treatment of malignant hypertension. The main aim is lowering the blood pressure too quickly may compromise tissue perfusion due to altered regulation and can cause cerebral damage. Even in presence of cardiac failure or hypertensive encephalopathy, a controlled reduction to a level of about 150-90 millimeter mercury over a period of 24 to 48 hours of is ideal. The drugs which treated malignant hypertension are intravenous labetalol, intravenous glycerol trinitrate, intravenous sodium nitroprusside, intramuscular hydralazine. These are drugs can be given in malignant hypertension, and also the patients require careful supervision. Thank you.